Sign up for a free membership at learn.ba to take the first 6 lessons of the BA Blocks program completely free of charge.
What do you do when you have a very large scope of analysis work, but very little time to do it in? That's the subject of this video. In this video, I want to talk to you about effective ways that you can cut corners in your analysis work to be able to hit certain deadlines if the schedule on your project is something that's non-negotiable. So let's say, for example, you're in a situation where your employer or your client has given you a project that requires a fairly large scope of work to be done, but the timelines that you have to be able to do that are severely condensed, right? There are certain things that you can do as an analyst to be able to operate in that environment. So hopefully you're not in an environment where that is the norm, where you're constantly having to do this. But there, from time to time, you will run into situations where that is just the it's just the reality of your situation, where the employer will say, yeah, we know that we haven't given you enough time to do this, but we have no option but to get it done by this time. No ifs, ands, or buts, right? And so you have to have certain strategies up your sleeve to be able to deliver under those types of severe constraints on a project. So I'm going to offer you 3 different tips on things that you can do to be able to still deliver a good solution, good analysis work for a solution under severe time constraints. The number one thing that I'm going to talk to you about is de-scoping. So this isn't a mystery. If you're given a large scope, your first strategy is to try to remove as much of the capabilities, as much of the functionality that's within your power without completely making the solution useless. So I'll talk about that a little bit, and I'll talk about how you can do that. Number two, I want to talk to you about deferring your analysis work as much as humanly possible into the future. And so there are certain things that you can do, and I'll give you some examples of what you can do to be able to defer work into the future. Number three, you have to cut all analysis overhead. Anything that doesn't, anything that's not oriented around making sure that you can deliver the analysis is stuff that you have to completely push out. And I'll give you some examples of that, because as an analyst, you're usually doing the analysis work and you're leading a lot of the analysis work, but there are usually a lot of very side tasks that you're expected to take part in as part of your role that are not directly contributing to the deliverables that you're producing. And so I'll talk a little bit about that. So let's tackle the first one, de-scoping. De-scoping, and before I jump into these, actually, I should tell you that each one of these things is going to make somebody on your project team unhappy. So for example, the very first one, de-scoping, is very likely going to make your customer or your client unhappy, because they originally expected to get a certain piece of scope, and now what you're telling them is that the quality of that might necessarily be exactly what you want it to be, or that there might be certain features that are completely missing. Deferring your work is going to make the development team very unhappy, because a lot of times when you're deferring your work, what you're doing is you're basically telling the developers, I'm not going to give you the level of detail that you really need to build this thing. You're going to need to make some assumptions, and I'll get you the details later on. The third one is going to make your project manager unhappy, right? Because if much of the overhead that you're trying to reduce, right, with your third strategy is these are the things that your project manager wants you to be able to carry forward in order for them to reduce risk on a project or to handle some of the communication, etc. So before we jump into them, just know that each one of these strategies is going to make somebody unhappy, and you should have some sort of a contingency plan for making sure that you know how to deal with some of the blowback that might come from the different people that you're making unhappy through these strategies that you're implementing. So let's talk about de-scoping. Normally, when you're given a scope statement, or if you're not given a scope statement, you're developing a scope statement, you have to be under severe time constraints. You have to be willing to say to your client, to your customer, to your project manager, anybody else on the team, we're not going to tackle that part of it. A lot of this means that you have to have some very strong domain knowledge to be able to make that judgment call on the spot. And if you're challenged on that, you have to be able to say, look, I know that you guys can still get your work done if you don't have this part of the solution, We'll find some workaround for that right now. What we need to do is we need to deliver the core of this piece. And so you have to be very good at being able to have those types of conversations with the different players on your project if you're going to be following that strategy of descoping. And remember, every one of these strategies is going to make somebody unhappy, and you have to make sure that you're dealing with the issues that pop up from these strategies that you're implementing, right? So that's descoping. Let's talk about deferring your work. So let's say, for example, in your analysis work, typically what you like to do is you write your use cases down to a very detailed level, right? You might be doing much more of the fully dressed use case style than the high level, you know, the user story or use case. With this strategy, what you have to do is you have to make sure that you don't go too far into the details. You give them just enough information, the dev team just enough information to be able to give them an idea of what needs to be done. They're gonna have a lot of follow-up questions, but what you do is you defer a lot of those questions to say, look, I'm gonna get you answers to these questions right now. I'm gonna get you answers to these questions in the future. But what I need you to do right now is I need you to make some assumptions and tell me what those assumptions are as you're doing the development work. And so what that does is it gives you the ability to defer a lot of your analysis work and still gives you something that you can hand over to the dev team for them to actually start being able to do some of their parts. Now, again, the developers are not going to be happy about this. And also, this strategy also has additional risks, because if the developers make a lot of assumptions that don't hold up in the future, that means that there's going to be rework for your project. So you have to make sure that you keep your project manager in the loop if you're following the strategy and letting them know, hey, look, I'm asking the developers to make a lot of assumptions. A lot of their assumptions might not hold up, which means that you're going to have more development time available for them to do rework, right? So that's the consequences of deferring your analysis work into the future. Cutting overhead. Let's say, for example, you have a daily meeting, a daily stand-up meeting, or let's say you have two bi-weekly meetings, or two weekly meetings, let's say, that you have to attend to be able to just answer general questions or just like a regular status update. You cut all of those. You decline them in your calendar and you tell people, I'm not attending these meetings unless you have specific questions that you need me to answer. And what that does is it frees up your time to make sure that you have more time, you're pulling more time from your calendar from other tasks that are non-core tasks into what you need to do. And again, people are not going to be unhappy. Project manager is not going to be very happy about you skipping a lot of these meetings, especially if it's something that, you know, if it's something that they do to build morale, or if they're saying that, you know, we need everybody in the team so we can kind of understand what's going on. You have to take a stance and you have to protect your time to be able to perform the analysis work when you're under severe conditions, right? And so that is one piece of overhead. Another piece of overhead that you can cut in from some of your analysis work is the formalization of documents. So if you're producing your requirements and your specification documents and you go through a formal process of validating them and getting them approved, what you need to tell the project manager is that, hey, we're not going to be able to follow this process and hit our deadline. So we need a quicker way. We need a more streamlined way to be able to get approvals for these, or to get validations and approvals for these things without going through a full day validation session with the client, for example. Because if you're spending a full day validating, means that you're taking a full day away from the analysis work that you should be doing on another piece of the scope, right? And so anytime you're under these conditions, you have to be very firm with defending the time that you have to be able to do the analysis work that needs to get done. So again, this is only under severe conditions, and it's only under severe conditions that you would implement all three of these different strategies. Normally, you have to kind of play it by ear, and you have to say, okay, well, which one of these can I implement and still be able to deliver the work, the scope of work in a short period of time, right? So you got to really kind of gauge the political environment. You got to gauge the different players and the types of pushback they're going to have. And you have to take a lot of things into account to figure out which ones of these strategies you're going to pursue. But these are three possible opportunities that you can use to try to reduce the analysis overhead, the scope, or whatever you need to do to be able to deliver to a very, very tight or very aggressive schedule. I'll leave the video there, and I will see you on the next video.